Hey, Kiosk Mode in Home Assistant is useful if you want to run Home Assistant on a tablet on the wall. It is also useful if you only want to give certain people in the house access to one dashboard and you want to hide the top and side menus. In this tutorial, I will show you how to set up Kiosk Mode in Home Assistant and how you can quickly switch between Kiosk Mode and Normal Mode yourself by using shielded buttons on your dashboard. Let's get started right away. You can set up Kiosk Mode in Home Assistant and then show it on a browser. If you want to do that beautifully, you can use Fully Kiosk browser for Android for this, for example. With the help of Fully Kiosk, you can actually lock the screen so you can't just go back to other functions of your tablet. In this Home Assistant tutorial, I'll show you two things. One is, how do I activate Kiosk Mode in Home Assistant? And the second one is, how can I easily switch between Kiosk Mode and Normal Mode? To activate Kiosk Mode, we are going to install a Hex integration. If you haven't installed Hex yet, you can do so by watching my video about it. The link is in the description below. The Kiosk Mode integration is maintained by Steven Kubrick since it was removed a couple of weeks back. So thanks Steven for forking this. The integration has several options. You can view the options yourself in the manual. In this tutorial, I'm just going to show you my best practice on how to apply Kiosk Mode. You can adjust that to your own taste, of course. First, we go to Hex. Then we click on Frontend. Then we click on Explore and Download Repositories. Search for Kiosk Mode. Click on Kiosk Mode. Click Download and click Download again. Now click Reload. Now the Kiosk Mode integration is installed in Home Assistant. Let's activate it. To do this, we go to the dashboard for which we want to turn on the Kiosk Mode. In this dashboard, we click on the three dots at the top right and then on Edit Dashboard. Then we click on the three dots again and choose Raw Configuration Editor. You will now see the YAML code of your dashboard. You might find this a little intimidating, but if you follow this tutorial, it's not that bad. What's very important in YAML is that you make sure that the indentation of spaces is correct, so keep that in mind when you're adding code. We are now going to add the following code. What we have done now is that we have turned on Kiosk Mode for everyone who is not an administrator of Home Assistant. So, if you set other family members not to be admin, they will see this dashboard as a Kiosk dashboard. Now click on Save and then click on the cross on the left above the dashboard. Now click on Done. You will see that nothing seems to have changed. This is, of course, because you are an administrator and we have just set up Kiosk Mode for anyone who is not an administrator. If I log in as someone who is not an administrator, you will see that that person no longer sees any menus. Now I'm going to do a trick by creating a helper, and based on the value in that helper, we are going to turn the Kiosk Mode on or off. Go to Settings and then Devices and Services. Then click on Helpers. Click Create Helper. Choose Toggle. Name the helper Kiosk Mode and create a helper. I already created that helper, so I don't need to create it again. Now we are going to create the buttons on our dashboard that turn the Kiosk Mode on or off. I use mushroom cards for this. If you don't have this, you can also install it via Hex. But you can also use a standard entities card for it if you like. Now go back to the dashboard where you added the Kiosk Mode code. Click on the three dots at the top right. Click on Edit Dashboard, click on Add Card, add a Mushroom Chips card, delete the first entity, click on Add Chip and select Menu. Click on Add Chip again and select Action. Click on the pencil next to Action. Select an icon, I choose MDI Arrow Expand Vertical. Select an icon color. I choose light green. Click Tap Action. Select Call Service. At Service, choose Input Boolean Toggle. Choose the entity Kiosk Mode. Click Save. Put your menu at the top and click Done. Oh, by the way, I also use the layout card in Hex by Thomas Loven, which gives you more control over the layout of your dashboard. This is also recommended to install. Search for layout card in Hex. This allows you to adjust the view type of your dashboard. I have it set to vertical layout card here. It's out of scope for this tutorial, but you can install it anyway. If my videos help you, and if you want to keep up to date with my tutorials and not miss anything to increase your knowledge of Home Assistant and Smart Home, subscribe to my channel and tick the bell. It also helps if you post a comment. This way, more people get notified about my videos. Oh, and don't forget to hit the thumbs up for this video. This allows me to make more tutorials for you. By supporting me, you also support my work as a music therapist to help people with mental issues. Thank you. You now see that when I press the menu icon, the menu is expanded or collapsed. On a desktop, you see that the menu will still remain visible for now. That's not the case on mobile. You can change that later so that the menu is not visible on a desktop either. I don't do that because as an administrator, I always want to see the menu on the left side. The green fold-out button doesn't do anything yet. At least what it does is convert the value of the Kiosk Mode helper from on to off and vice versa. But it doesn't turn Kiosk Mode on and off yet. To do that, let's go to the three dots at the top right again. Click on Edit Dashboard. Click again on the three dots at the top right. Click on Raw Configuration Editor. Now replace the kiosk code you added with this code. Click Save. Click on the cross at the top left of your dashboard. Click on Done. And now refresh your browser. This is important, otherwise it won't work the first time. The code toggles the height header to true or false based on the input boolean kiosk mode. You will now see that the green button toggles kiosk mode on and off if you are an administrator. If you're a user, that button and the menu button don't do anything. Now, of course, we don't want the user to see those buttons, so we're going one step further. To show certain dashboard buttons based on the user's role, we need a different Hex integration. This integration is called State Switch and was created by Thomas Loven. Using this integration, you can enable or disable cards on your dashboard based on a certain status. It has several options that you can view in the integration manual. For our use case, we now only use the control on a group. It can have the value user or admin. It's a pretty powerful integration, so if you want to learn more about it, be sure to read the manual. The link is in the description below. By the way, you should really check out all the integrations that Thomas Loven created. They are totally awesome. The link to his GitHub is in the description below. For this, we go back to Hex. Click on Frontend. Click on Explore and Download Repositories. Search for State Switch. Click State Switch. Click Download and then click Download again. Then click on Reload. The State Switch integration is now installed. Let's apply it to our Kiosk dashboard. For that, we go back to our Kiosk dashboard. Click on the three dots at the top right. Click on Edit Dashboard. Now click on Edit in your chips card. The State Switch entity currently does not have a GUI, so we need to add the code in YAML. Thomas Loven wants to make a GUI for that, but there's no planning for it yet. So, for now, we are going to add the code in YAML. Click Show Code Editor. Replace the code in the code editor with this code. Click Save and click Done. What we've now done is that we have indicated that the two buttons should only be shown if someone is administrator. Let's test this. Exciting! As you can see, I see the buttons because I am administrator. Now when I log in as a user who is not an administrator, I don't see those buttons and I'm locked in this dashboard and can't access anything else. I did the same for the two buttons stats and server that are on the dashboard. They are also only visible to people with the administrator role. With the help of the state switch integration, you can do a lot more things and even show cards only for specific users. I think you can now make this yourself based on the information in this tutorial. So, now you can create the kiosk mode yourself for your tablet or your other family members. Let me know in the comments if it worked. I hope it was of some use to you. I want to thank everyone who has supported me in making these videos so far. I could never have done this without you. Thank you. Oh, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and hit the notification bell. See you soon. Bye bye.